All right, guys, not the best view, and they're all gone deep into the bush now, so let's just carry on with our drive and see what else we can find on the road. So this is what elephants do. If he can show you on the left, push a tree down just to get to the bark and the leaves. That happened quite a while ago though. It's not really recent. Well, actually it could be because of the fire. So that tree was quite burnt by the fire, and then an elephant just came and push it forward to get access to the bark, maybe strip a little bit of, to strip the bark. Okay. The elephants have quite a big impact on the vegetation. Pushing trees over and striping barks of trees. That's why when you have a surpopulation, overpopulation of elephants, it can be quite a problem, eh? It could be quite bad for the vegetation. Good morning, Stuart, in Scotland. How's the weather there in Scotland? I hear that it rains a lot. Is that true? I wonder. Anyway, welcome to Juma, Scotland. Welcome to Juma, Scott. Stuart. Get confused between the names and the countries. Stuart wants to know if hippos move from waterhole to another one, or if they usually stay always in the same waterhole. Yes, they would move, Stuart, from one place to another one. You can, if a waterhole gets a bit too dry, then they will get out of it and they'll find another one. And also what you must know is at night they will move around that waterhole. They would go and graze. They would leave the waterhole at night to go and graze in the surrounding areas around the waterhole. And they can cover quite large distances at night, actually. And if they do get, while they're grazing, if they come upon another waterhole which is not occupied, because hippos are very territorial, so if a waterhole is occupied, they will not get into.
Hi, everybody. Mark, yeah, sorry about that. Looks like we're having a bit of a problem from the vehicle. I'm going to try and cut back to Seb for a few minutes. I think we have a battery issue. I think this could be my fault from... I might have made a mistake putting it on charge last night. But anyways, we're going to cut back to Seb and we'll see what we can do. We might only be able to go on for a couple of more minutes just for Seb to say goodbye. And I'll be back after the end of drive.
Welcome back, guys. I can't stay too long because the batteries are dying, so we're gonna have to go back and put the vehicle in charge. And we don't have sound. Just let me know when we have sound. Okay. Sorry, Mark thought we didn't have sound. All right. The equipment is really getting is dying now, so I'm gonna have to go and put the vehicle in charge. Thanks for being with us this morning. And we'll go again this afternoon for sure at 3:30 Central African time. I'll be presenting. Becky will be behind the camera and Mark in FC. So thank you for all your questions this morning, and I will see you a little bit later. We need to charge the batteries now. Bye, folks.
Hi, everyone. Oh, that's why I don't get sound, because I turn the speakers down to talk to you, and then when I get back to Seb, I don't hear anything. Hi, all. Hope you enjoyed the morning with Seb and Becky. Wonderful to see those hyenas again. And it's not only Karula and the cubs that we have to watch growing up. It's also great to have other animals and their children. I guess I do have to take the blame for this. I made a mistake connecting the batteries last night, and so the vehicle wasn't charged properly, and so we're going to bring it back, put it on charge, and everything should be fine for the PM drive this afternoon. My elbows again. So I'm just going to quickly check in chat. Also, yes, nice to see so many new viewers, and welcome to all our new viewers. We do have a few hurdles trying to broadcast from the bush. For those of you new viewers, it's not all straightforward. We're using a lot of equipment that should be indoors and that's on the vehicle, driving around a dusty African bushveld. So we have the odd hurdle every now and then. Anyways, this is Juma Game Reserve. We've been with us on our live morning safari, and we will be out again this afternoon at 3:30 Central African time. Do join us then. Have a very good day. Those of you going to bed, sweet dreams. You get to go to bed 15 minutes early today. Good night. Sleep tight. And for those of you who might be visiting or have contact with Tim or Libby or any of Shelley's family, please pass on our best to both ladies. Hope that they are recovering well and not too nauseous after anesthesia, etc., etc. I am following